Are you looking for the best blogging niche ideas for 2020? Well, I think I found one of the most amazing niches and I'm going to show it here to you in this video. Check this out. According to this analysis, this website gets 363,000 organic visitors per month. We can safely multiply it by two to get the real number because this tool always understates it by two or three times. So we'll multiply 363,000 visitors by two. That gives us 726,000 visitors per month completely free. And if we multiply it by approximately 2 cents per visitor, which is a very conservative estimate of the profitability of this traffic, we get $14,520 per month that this website is making just from ads, plus actually a lot more from affiliate marketing. In this video, I'm going to break it all down for you, show you what this niche is and why I think it's the best blogging niche for 2020. Stay tuned. On this channel, I publish regular videos about the best niches for blogging. So check out the card in the top right corner and also the links in the description below if you want to see my other videos with more excellent niches for you to get into. So today's niche is a gardening niche. And it is a niche that is completely underutilized. People are not building enough blogs in it. There is a ton of search traffic and people are spending a lot of money on their gardens. So you can actually make a lot of money from affiliate marketing, from Google Ads, from AdThrive, from MediaVine and more. Personally, I have built a lot of blogs in a lot of different niches in my blogging career. And I know how frustrating it can be when you're trying to start a blog and you just go and spend hours and days and weeks looking for the perfect blogging niche and that doesn't have too much competition and that is quite easy to publish content in. And this website that I'm going to show you today is a very good case study for the gardening niche because this niche is quite easy to produce the content in. You don't have to have any special skills or knowledge. You don't have to have any accreditation. You don't have to have any credentials. For example, you know, people who try to teach weight loss niches and various exercises, you know, you either need to be buff or you need to have a really good figure. But in this niche, none of that applies. Anyone, like whoever, wherever you are and, you know, no matter what your background is, if you're watching this today, you can actually start a successful, profitable blog in this niche that I'm going to show you today. So this website, Gardener's Path, let's just talk about it for a little bit. You can start a website just like this. This website here, Gardener's Path, if we look at About Us, this was actually started by this person here, Michael Quinn, in 2014. So it has been around for a while, about 5-6 years. It is not a corporate website, so there is no huge company behind it. It's just a person just like you and me from his home that decided to start this blog and has managed to grow it to a huge business over this period of time. Let's take a look at this domain here inside the Ahrefs tool. So if we go into the organic search tab, we can see that their traffic really only started picking up about 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago in January 2018. That's when they started publishing a lot of content and things started picking up. So there's been a big growth in terms of the organic traffic per month that they're getting. So this website is currently ranking for 389,000 different organic keywords, which are bringing this amount of visitors to the website. Now, from my own experience, I've analyzed my own sites. This figure is always too low. They're probably getting closer to 1 million visitors per month. At least I would say 700,000 to 800,000. And the best thing that I like about this niche and about this website is that if we look at the actual keywords, I'm gonna click here, I'm gonna show you the types of keywords that this website is currently ranking for. And the keywords that they've chosen are actually extremely easy to rank for. So this here we've got 285,000 keywords on US Google. Now I'm going to apply a keyword difficulty of 5. 5 is a very low keyword difficulty. If you decide to start a brand new blog in this niche today, you can rank with good content, you can rank for KD5 keywords. Okay, so all of these keywords, 126,000, they are easy to rank for keywords that any beginner blog, as long as they write high quality content the way that I show on my channel and in my course, you can rank for these keywords on page one. So let's take a closer look here. Keyword difficulties here, you can see how many keywords with massive search volume and very low keyword difficulty there are in this niche. Peak and trees, 2,500 searches per month. Keyword difficulty is 0. This is shocking. Look at this one, Mexican oregano plant. 1,100 searches per month on the US Google alone. Keyword difficulty of one, they're ranking of course one. If we drop this down, this SERP button here, I just want to show you something. So the key thing that I always look at is this AR. So AR stands for Ahrefs rank. And this indicates on a scale from 1 to about 150 million, how strong a domain is. So a very low score is means it's a very strong domain. A score of 1 million, 2 million, 4 million, 5, 6 million, etc. means that this domain is weak. So here on page 1, what we actually see for Mexican oregano plant is that there are some domains that are insanely weak that are ranking for this keyword. So this one here, advice from the herb lady. Okay, 14 million. So this means that this website is insanely weak and it is ranking on page 1. This next one, austinnativelandscaping.com, 19 million. There's one more. colonialcreekfarm.com, 22 million. So this is a super weak website and it is managing to rank on page 1 for this keyword here, Mexican oregano plant. Now let's look at the actual content that is ranking and let's see how easy or how hard it is for you to produce this kind of content. So first let's look at this one here, advice from the herblady.com. Let's check how hard it is for you to produce this kind of content. All right, so drum roll please. This is the whole content. There is nothing else. So let's see how many words. 313 words. Do you think you can write 313 words about Mexican oregano herb and rank on page 1? You absolutely can, okay? So then let's take a look at this one, the next one, Austin Native Landscaping. So this one here, how many words have they put? So 104 words, 104 words on a page is ranking over here on page 1. This is insane. It means that if you start a website today, brand new website, no backlinks, and you publish content on Mexican oregano plant, that is, let's say, 1,000 to 1,500 words long. Once again, if you're new to my videos, long-form content ranks extremely well on Google. Okay, so if you publish 1,000 to 1,500 words on this plant, just create an awesome resource, you will have an extremely good chance of getting onto page 1 and ranking your post for Mexican oregano plant. Now, this is just one keyword. There are 126,000 different keywords with, if you open them up and you analyze them time and time again, very short content on very weak domains is ranking on page 1. So if you start a website today in this niche and you analyze and you write content on these same keywords, you will have an amazing chance of ranking on page 1 of Google with your site in this niche. There's just one more example here, gopher plant, that's another keyword. Once again, we're seeing very weak AR scores, 12 million, very low, 5.1, 3.1, 1.1, 17 million. All of the content here is very, very short and they're managing to rank on page 1. The other cool thing is that all of these pages that are ranking on page 1, they've got no backlinks. Zero backlinks, zero backlinks, zero backlinks. These ones says I've got 2, 4, or 5. I've actually looked into them. They are kind of spammy links. They don't even count. Okay, so pretty much all of these results here on page 1 do not have any backlinks at all. They're just newbie sites, very weak domains, publish this content on this keyword and they're on page 1. So now let's move on to monetization. How do you actually make the money? So once you've decided what you're going to write about, how do you make money? Well, let's look at it from the customer journey perspective. So let's say I'm interested in the Mexico oregano plant. I type it into Google. And of course, the first result, as we already know from the previous section, is this website that we're looking at, this gardener's path. So I will open this up. And as I am reading this content, I can see that there are ads that come up. So there is an ad that's popped in here on the right-hand side in the sidebar, okay? There is also an ad here at the bottom, which says download this PDF. So this is an ad. There is also an ad here that I can see. This is an ad. There are more ads throughout the content. And of course, a lot of people who are reading these blog posts, they will end up clicking the ads. And the moment somebody clicks on any of these ads that are here on this website, the owner of Gardener's Path makes money. We already know that these kind of ads through AdThrive, MediaVine, or Google AdSense pay approximately $20 to $40 per 1,000 visitors in these sort of niches, like gardening niche and other hobby niches. And as we know, this website most likely gets at least 700,000 page views per month. So if we multiply 700,000, okay, we divide it by 1,000 and we multiply it by 20, we know that this website makes probably at least $14,000 per month just from these ads alone, completely passively. There are other ways that this website makes money. I just don't know exactly how much, but there'd be a certain amount, I'm sure, at least several thousand more, maybe 10,000 more per month from affiliate marketing. So on a lot of their guides, like this one here, 5 of the best hori hori knives for gardeners, there are links, affiliate links to Amazon. Now we know that Amazon just dropped the commissions to 1 to 2%, but still obviously it all counts and all helps. If somebody is reading this article and they click on this link, it's available from Nisako via Amazon, you can see that if they buy something via this link, so after they click on this link, if they buy anything on Amazon, the owner of this site will get the commission on everything. So let's say if somebody buys this knife that is talked about here, but also ends up buying an Xbox or a DVD player or whatever it is that they decide to buy, a stereo system, then the owner of this website will get paid a commission on the whole amount. So it might be just 1% commission on the knife, but it's also 1% commission on the $1,000 TV. And it all can add up over time to a really nice amount of money. So let's say you like this niche and you decide to actually start a blog in this niche. Here is a brief process for what you can do to become successful and start a profitable blog in this niche. By the way, if you want to see the full guide, you can get it in the link in the description below. I've got a video start to finish that tells you how to start a blog, how to build it, how to grow it. And also I'm going to put a card here in the top right corner as well. But the process is that you need to, of course, firstly set up your website, buy the domain, set up your hosting, etc., get all of that out of the way. Then you need to publish 1 to 5 articles per week. You need to choose keyword difficulty under 5 in Ahrefs. So you could reverse analyze this website, Gardener's Path, or any of the other websites really that are competing for some of these keywords on page 1, and then enter the keyword difficulty of maximum 5 and start publishing articles on these keywords here. If you don't know anything about the gopher plant or about bachelor buttons or all of this other stuff, you can just do your own research, read up, you know, perhaps 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 other articles and create your own guide, but make sure that it's firstly longer than all the other content out there, and secondly, that is at least as good quality or ideally even better quality than all the other content on page 1. Google knows that long content and content that is well written and well presented, you know, is the content that the visitors want to see. So they will give priority to your content over the competitors' content if your content is longer. One of the things I get asked time and time again is, can I just copy and paste someone else's content into my own blog? No, you cannot. Your content has to be original and unique. You need to write it from scratch. So you can write something in your own words. You can look at someone else's article and rewrite it in your own words, but you can never copy other people's content. If you don't have time to write, you can actually outsource your content on Upwork. Usually in 2 to 6 months, your traffic will start to significantly pick up. So don't expect to publish one article and wait for the traffic to start rolling in. That's not going to happen. It takes Google some time to start trusting your website and they want to see consistent posting. So you need to publish 1 to 5 articles per week. And after 2 to 6 months, depending how often you publish, your traffic will start to significantly pick up and it will start growing. For example, here are the analytics stats for one of my blogs, and you can see that we started it in May 2019, and for the first 3 months we're barely getting any traffic. We started getting 200-300 by the 3 month mark, and guess what, most people give up here. They don't persevere, they don't continue publishing content, they give up. And if I did the same thing, then I would have missed out on all of this traffic that our site is now getting automatically. The site is just growing really fast. And yeah, we've had a few setbacks during Christmas, and then the pandemic sort of ruined the interest in our niche a little bit, but it will come back after to sort of this amount of like 5, 6 and more thousand daily visitors after the pandemic is over. So be patient. As you saw, it took us good few months to actually for the site to start taking off. But once it did, it just went and started growing very, very quickly. Once you start getting 100 visitors per day, apply to Google AdSense and insert Google AdSense auto ads into your blog posts. This is a very good way to monetize your blog post, and the revenue per 1,000 visitors is actually really, really good. It's almost on par with these other networks that I've put here, MediaVine and AdThrive. Now, MediaVine and AdThrive do pay more, but you need to meet some minimum criteria. So with MediaVine, your site needs to get at least 25,000 visitors per month. So it's close to 1,000 per day. And with AdThrive, at least 100,000 per month. They do have these thresholds, but they do tend to pay more. So once your site starts getting 25,000 per month and then 100,000 per month, it's a very good idea for you to switch over to MediaVine and AdThrive to test and see if you're making more money than with Google AdSense. Chances are you probably will, because they just pay more, they've got that reputation, but you ultimately, it's up to you to figure out whether it's MediaVine or AdThrive or Google AdSense that actually makes you more money. We can see, for example, that Gardener's Path use AdThrive. I looked up the back end of their code and I typed in AdThrive, and we can see that there is AdThrive code in here. So for them, AdThrive seems to be doing really, really well. If you want to get my free affiliate and blogging training, then I'm going to drop the links in the description below where I show how to go from zero to making 10,000 or more per month with affiliate marketing and blogging. Watch the next couple of videos just here on the screen. You're going to love those other videos related to blogging and affiliate marketing. And make sure to subscribe to my channel if you are new to my channel. I'd love to connect with you and keep an eye out for my next videos. Thank you for watching.